What is going on, everyone? What is SCSI? This is a question that I get more than probably any other question. SCSI seems to be a mystery to everyone, and for good reason. So today we're going to answer a couple of questions, and this is a part two. I have an earlier video just covering the very basics of what SCSI is, and more specifically how it interfaces with the EPS-16+. But today we're going to dig a little bit deeper. So SCSI stands for Small Computer System Interface. And what SCSI is basically a connector type or an interface that allowed data to transfer from peripheral device to peripheral device. So a similar interface for today's times would be USB. Today, USB is the same sort of transfer device that's used to transfer data from one peripheral device to another. But back in the day, long time ago, when these vintage samplers that are making a comeback today were in vogue, there was no such thing as USB. There wasn't anything as fast as we have today. So we had SCSI. And SCSI at the time was the absolute future. I remember the first time I made the jump from floppy disk to SCSI, and the transfer rates just blew my mind. And the fact that you can save so much on a little zip disk was amazing. Like 100 megabytes was out of this world. Quick little story. I remember in university when a friend of mine got a desktop computer, and that computer came stocked with a whopping 6 gig hard drive. We were absolutely blown away. I had never heard of a computer with that much hard drive space in my life. Like, that was out of this world. Even more unbelievable, my first laptop came with 100 megabytes of hard drive space. So it just goes to show you how much we come along in the way of storage space. And this is something that's actually taken for granted. So with all the space that we have today, people always ask me, why don't I upgrade? And here's the answer. I still operate on a floppy drive mentality. 100 megabytes of storage space is ample for me. I'm pretty economical with my samples and the way that I make my music, and it doesn't require me to have anything larger than that. It takes me so long to fill up 100 megabytes of disk space that I often just use floppies because, believe it or not, they're almost more versatile for me. So that is it. SCSI is nothing more than a transfer protocol. It was, at the time, a very fast method to transfer data from one unit to the other. And a lot of manufacturers saw it fit to use that as a standard for transferring data. Now, things are beginning to move faster, better, and space is just becoming more infinite. Now, the question for you is, does this help you make better music? Or sometimes do you wish for some sort of limitation on the space that you have available in the instruments that we use today? Let me know your thoughts. Ask your questions below. But that's all for now on SCSI. As always, subscribe to me here on YouTube, follow me on Facebook, follow me on Instagram, follow me on Twitter. And as always, you can find all you need to know about me at thedaydreamsound.com. Peace. What is up, everyone? I'm dropping a new album today. It's called Formations in Rhythm, and it is available at Bandcamp, at thedaydreamsound.com, and it is heavy. Continues the ebook story that I've been writing since Passage to Akebulan, and this is the latest chapter. It is heavy, it's deep, just like this album. You're gonna love it.